So we start with we start with our this one, case statement today, because it is known to everyone that if condition is met, then if one single statement is there, then begin and end is not required. Else, we can come to another statement. If here are multiple statements, then we need a begin. And we need end here. If multiple statements are there. Guys, if you are losing the connectivity, kindly update me on WhatsApp group. Just a moment. Let me close the WhatsApp here. Sounds are coming out. Okay. So now here, after this else, if we have multiple statements, again the same story, we can have this begin and end here. So what if multiple, like if this is a condition, and then else, if then condition check, and then finally you can have else. If else is a ladder, this is finally else. This is also possible. One is simply if condition and then statement. This is one way. The second is this one. The third is this one. If else space if, and then finally else. This is the third. So there are three ways. This way we can have conditional execution of the statements. So in this, if condition is true, this is true, expression is true, then the following statements are executed. Else, then other following statements are executed. So that's how the condition, if condition is true, then this is what happening. So instead of having if you have lot many conditions to check, if there are several conditions to check, then you can do with if, else, if, else if, such. This is going to be a bit what to say, bit verbose here, a lot of things, several times you have to keep writing like that. So multi-branching is possible. This is sort of multi-branching. If this is true, then here. Otherwise, if this is true, then here. Multi-branching. So instead this, we can come up with another possibility, that is case statement. That is case statement. So in this case statement, this is a lot easier than this approach. Multi-branching, we call this as a multi-branching. It's a lot easier than this one. The same thing, instead case, this also will do that. But several times you else if instead this way of writing, and then finally writing else, you can go for this one case. So in the case, the syntax is, you have the case and the case expression. This case expression. If this expression is meeting this case value, if meeting this case value, whatever the case value, not necessarily 0, 1, 2, it could be anything, 128, it could be anything, 130, it could be anything. So if this case expression is meeting any of the values here, then the corresponding, for that, this is the column syntax, and here statements are executed. This topic, though earlier been taken up, but why the reason I pick it up today we are going to wind up our this ongoing class. The reason why I took up this is some important point here. I forgot to tell that point is, there are two ways of having this case. One is, carefully listen, if you have queries to ask. One is, this is first and second. The first is you can have the case and this here expression. I am simply keeping exp expression. And here that I say case value CV, CV1, CV2, case value 1, case value 2, like that. So here order is not important here. Case value 3, this order, you know, just let me fix. I can put this CV2 here or I can put this CV3 here. And this CV1 I can put here. And this CV2 I can keep here somewhere here. Order is not important here in this case. In this first case, order is not important. This case values in which order you keep, that is not important. Now the other is very, very crucial. You pay attention. Now what I do is case, I put 1, suppose case 1, meaning case true. Now, the case value here, what I am keeping, let us say this is case value 1 again, you take case value 2, case value 3, and so on. Here, this order is important here. The condition is first tested with the very first one. If this is true. This order is important. In which priority? You have to have, as a designer, you have to have a plan that if I use a case 1 instead of this case expression, this type, instead of this type, if I use this type, then what is that you have to have in your mind while you code? This first expression that you keep is the priority taken by this case in a case where you are using, instead of case expression, if you are using case 1 here, then you should have in your mind that it is first going to match with the very first one itself. In that case, you cannot put this CV1 here somewhere. If you are thinking that CV1 should be given higher priority, then it should be here itself. Suppose say you have CV7. Suppose say CV7 needs to be given higher priority. Then CV7 must be here. And CV1 needs to be given last priority, then CV1 should be here. You cannot put elsewhere here CV1. Neither you can keep here the very first. So for example, let us take one example so that you better understand with example. We have our priority encoder. So everyone knows what is that priority encoder is. I have I3, I2, I1, I0. And I'm giving it to a priority encoder. These are the inputs. Okay, now this is my output here. So I am truth table is I3, I2, I1, I0. Now when this is 1, irrespective of all this, my output here, Y1, Y0, this one will be like 1, 1. Now, when this is 0 and this is 1, irrespective of these two lines, my output is this 1, 0. Now, irrespective of this one, this may be 1, this may be 0, my output is 0, 1. Now these are zeros and this is 1, then this is 0, 0. So this is our priority encoder functionality. So this is the priority. Why we call priority? Because here this may be 1, this may be 1, this may be 1 also. All are maybe 1s, but the priority is given to this line. How we are knowing that priority is given to this I3? Because of this output. Output is, if you see, this is 1 and this is 1, that is line 3. The value is line 3. Line 3 is high now. That is what we are understanding from this, looking at this output here, this 3. We are understanding that this is 1. And this, and though these are 1s, we are not caring. This is the priority given to this one, this encode, priority encode. Is that clear to everyone, this concept?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, how do we model this one? We model in two different ways. As been said here earlier, case expression and a case, the other method is case one. So let us see the this one, modeling. So you are modeling here case expression. You are going to keep here case expression. In your case expression, you have your I3, comma I2, comma I1, comma I0. So just a moment, I remove this one here. Okay, let us write neatly. So you have the case, and inside the parentheses, you are going to keep what? Case expression, I3, I2, and I1, and I0. This is not correct. So what is required is concatenate. You have to concatenate this. So you have concatenated using the concatenation operator, these braces. Now, if this is going to match with something like 4 tick B, 1, X, 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 like this case is not going to work out for to match this X here. So for that, what we have to do is we have to use that case X. We have another case Z also. This case Z, what it does here in the expression, here in the value here, if Z is there, then only it matches case expression with the case value. If there is a Z, if there is a X, then it is not going to match. This is not going to work out. This is not going to work out. Case Z is not going to work out. Case X is there means if in the case value, if X is there or Z is there, both it is going to look out for this case X. So that's why what we prefer is case X usage. Is that clear to everyone there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now what we do is colon, and here the output, here we have Y1 comma Y0, and we to tick B11. Now the other one here is 4 tick B. You can put anything, as been said earlier, 0, 0, 1x also you can put. Not necessarily in order wise you have to come. Can someone mute? Somebody unmuted? Is that clear from my side? Voice, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, see, this order is not a matter here. Now, what I'm going to do here is 4 tick B, 4 tick B. Now, let us pick some other the 0, 0, 0, 1. Now, I'm going to put here 4 tick B. What is left? 0, 1, X, X. So this order, see, I did not maintain any order here. Now this follows here. This is Y1 comma Y0, and then this is according to that. This is 2 tick B, 1 0 semicolon. This is Y1 comma Y0, and then what you have here, 2 tick B, 0 0, and then this one. This is Y1 comma Y0, and then this is 2 tick B 1 0. This is 0 1. This is 1 line 1, meaning this is 0 1. This one, this is 2 tick B 1 0. So this is how I have completed. If you see the order here, this order, you know, case value order, we did not maintain here. In any order we wrote here. So now if you are following this one here, case one. So what is the priority that we have in our mind? I3, right? Is it not? In our mind, what is the priority that we have? I3, right? According to the priority encoder, we have I3, right? Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So now that's the reason why we have to put here I3 and then I2. Next priority is I2. Next priority is I1. Next priority is I0. Now see the difference here. Here difference if you see here. What we have here is this is actually in fact this is matching with this one. This is 0 0. This is 1. This is maybe x. This you keep x meaning 1, right? 1 line 1, and line 1 you have kept here. And here if you see this the other side here, line 1 in the second position, first position, second position you have kept, just because you are using case of 1. You are not using here inside expression, you are not using expression, you are not using. So this is the priority. This case of 1, what it does is the priority order it follows. It first compares with the first one, first option. If this is true, then followed by that, whatever the statements are there, they are executed. If the, in case if this is the first priority is failed, then it will go to the second one. Then if it is failed, then it will go to the third one. Likewise, this case of one is working, whereas the other way around here you have this one. In that case expression when it is going to match with any of the values here that you have provided, order is not important. That is the point that I'm trying to make out here. Is that clear to everyone? The usage of case expression and case one to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the point number one of today's that I thought of completing. The next one is, let us go to another. So let us say we have 101. We are talking about now your presence, finite state machine. A simple example is we are taking 101. So we have to detect the pattern detector sort of thing. So you are getting some pattern here, sequence detector, some sequence are coming in, and when particular sequence is met, then your output should go high. Your output should go high. So a sequence is coming in here. And you have for that, you have the clock, and you have reset. Because this is after all a FSM, finite state machine, you have to have the reset also. Because inside the components are combinational as well as sequential. So reset is required. Now before even discussing the FSM, we must have the basic idea of two finite state machines. That we have, one is a Moore type, the other is a Mealy type. We say that if this is our input circuit one, and you have something here, your sequential circuit here. Or this is, you can also call as a combinational circuit 1 or input circuit, and you have another combinational circuit here 2 or output circuit. This is called output circuit or combinational circuit. This is circuit 2. Now if your inputs are coming here to this one, and if your output, this output is dependent on solely on the states here. Some states are coming from the sequential circuits, and this, some states are going here, some states are fed back here, and this is your input. Now if you look at this particular diagram, it is very obvious to say to anyone that this output is actually dependent on the states here, current states here. These are the current states. And this is also called in some books next state generation logic, NS. Next state generation logic, this input side here, this circuitry, whatever is there, input side. This is also called next state generation logic. And this circuit is also called output generation logic, output generation logic. Now this output generation logic, if you see, the output is solely dependent on the current states. It is not dependent on this input. It's directly not dependent. Of course, this input also causes here, it affects the output. But according to the figure, if you see, this output directly not involved in changing the output. This input is not directly involved in changing the output. So such a type of circuit we categorize as a Murray type FSM, finite state machine. So in the same circuit here, if this input, whatever coming, is also going here and affecting the directly on the output. If this is directly going here and also along with the current states, and the input is also involved in changing this output, directly involved, this input is directly involved, then we say it's a Mealy type of FSM, finite state machine. Of course, there are differences, advantages and disadvantages, like some states are less in Mealy, and the clock also it takes less, because giving the output it takes one clock less. All such theory is there. You can refer any switching theory, logic design, STLD book, switching theory and logic design book. But the basic fundamental concept is this, that if you have this two types, if output is directly dependent on the current states, then it is a Murray. If output is not dependent directly, it is along with the current states, it is also depending on the inputs, then such a circuit, such a FSM is called Mealy type FSM. So two types of FSMs are there. So now, if based on this knowledge, just now what we have discussed, if one we can code here this 101 in a Murray as well as Mealy. Now in the Murray type, we have, let us say, if your machine is there in some state, so we have to give some name to this state. Maybe some books may start with the saying that it is a reset state. Some say directly it is yes not state. Let us say yes not, something like that. So the point here is, when you power on, your machine should go into some known state. So we are calling that some state. We follow yes not. Yes not is some state. When you press reset, you are coming to a state called yes not state. And from this state, before going to this development, state diagram development, what we call this is state diagram development. We have to develop state diagram. After state diagram, then we can develop the code. Without state diagram, we cannot develop the code directly. So now, what is that we forgot here is, this: there are two types of sequences. There are two types. One is overlapping. So this is the overlapping sequence, and there is a non-overlapping sequence. There is a non-overlapping sequence. In a non-overlapping sequence, 101, after the completion of the sequence, a fresh 101 is sought, is looked for. In a overlapping sequence, 101, the end bit of this is a start bit for the another sequence. If you see this one, this one is actually is also a part of this, and also is a part of the this sequence. And not necessarily the end bit alone. In some example cases, what happens is, if you are looking for some sort of 1010, let us say, so the two bits may be a part of next sequence also. That sort of sequences also may be possible. meaning is we have to understand the specification. Basically, it is the part of specification. Specification. This should be clear for us to develop the state diagram. Specification should be clear for us to develop the state diagram. Here, if you see specification, this is possible, right? If you take this 101, the N2 bits are starting bit for the next sequence. It's also possible. Not necessarily the in this case, like end bit, only one bit is a end bit and also a start bit for the next sequence. Is that clear to what I'm trying to make the point here? Not necessarily one bit, two bits, three bits, depending upon the requirement specification. Is that clear what I'm trying to make, bring the point here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now if we assume first this one non-overlapping. Non-overlapping means 101 and then a fresh 101. You can try from home for overlapping. So let us say we are there here in the reset state. And this state is S0. Being in this state, if we are getting a 0, we don't have any interest in preserving that 0. That's why we are going to be in that state only. Because we don't want to capture this one. We don't want to look for that one 0. We want to look for if sequence is coming here, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, maybe, or maybe 0, 0, 0, 1, then we don't have interest in all zeros. When the first one comes, then we have the interest to catch this. So for that reason, when zeros are coming, we are not going to capture them. We stay in that state itself. And in the Moore machine, in the state itself, we show the output here. This output here. Here, output is 0. Output is 0. So, just a moment, here this one. Okay. Now, this is getting clear. This is zero output. This is state. This is the state. And this one is your output. And this one is your input. When input is 0, we are there in the one initial state. This S0 is the initial state. If you are pressing reset, then also we are there in the initial state. Now, if 1 comes, every transition is happening. This is called transition. This is called what is happening? Transition. This transition occurs at the clock edge. Clock edge is the clock edge. So this transition took place. So 0, we don't have interest. Now we move to this one here. When 1 comes here as input, we move to another state and we call that is from S1. This is when 1 has come as the input. Now you are understanding with this transitions, what we are showing, this one is the input. This is the input. Each time I don't need to write. So this is input. Now, when this is input, we have to catch this one. We have to preserve this one. We have to hold for a while this one. And this is the state which is holding that one. But it's that itself is not the complete sequence. That's why output is still 0. Now, being in this state, there are two possibilities. 0 may come or 1 may come. If 1 comes, what? If 1 comes means you have preserved one, and then another one may be coming, several such ones may come. After that, 0 may come, and then 1 may come, right? So in that case, these several ones, you don't need to preserve them. You don't need to hold. You can override them. You can override them. You don't need to preserve. Preserving means you have to create a state. You have to create a state. Yes, to one state. When 1 has come. Meaning you are holding actually 2 ones now. 2 ones. How many such ones you can hold? it is not practical, right? Our system is looking for this incoming sequence of bits. Sequence of bits may come, all 1 1 1 1 1 1, but we don't have any interest in all such ones. We are looking for a pattern called 101. So in such case, we can override this instead of preserving. So you write here, overwrite here, and you when one is coming. You don't create a state here. So just a moment. Because we don't want to preserve that one, because we don't have interest in that. If a bunch of ones are coming, we override them. Now, when zero is coming, we have to capture that zero, because we are looking for 1 0. We have to capture. Then we go to another state, and that is S2, and still output zero, and this is a zero, when zero being detected. Why we are not going to this one here? Question may come here. If zero coming, why we are not going to this one? What is the point of going to that one? We have to question, because 1 0, if you are going to that state, what is the problem? I am telling you. If you are going to that state, you had gone to that state, because this is the state where zero been held. This, if you see this one. So, but after that, what then? What is that you are going to do? Again, you are going to look for another one. Another one. Actually, what is expected, since you met the pattern completion, what is expected? Actually, output is expected. But if you see in this state, what is the output? Output is zero, right? Output supposed to be one, no, here. Output supposed to be the one. But if you see, output zero, no? So that's why we don't go to this state. Because if you go to that state, the problem is that. Now what we do, we go to, being in this state again, zeros may come, 1 0, then several zeros may come. Whether we have to preserve them or we have to override them, that is the question. Preserving means, again, you go to the another state, hold that is the sort of thing. We don't want to preserve, we don't want to hold such. So we don't want to go to the another state. That's why we don't go to the another state when zeros are coming. Can we override the such zeros? Answer is, again, no. Why? Because we are not looking for a zero. After that, immediately we are looking for one, right? Why should we take care of all those zeros occurring? Is that clear, this point here? This being in S2,
yes,
being in this S2, if zero is encountered, some may think that we have to override the way we have written here, one. Like this, zero is coming. Like the way we have written here, this one, we may have to write here also like that. Some may think like that. The problem is that if bunch of series of ones are coming, then what? There may be chance that zero may come again, one may come. For that, these ones we don't really want to lose them. Rather, we want to override, and we don't want to preserve also. Simply overriding. But what is then if zeros are coming like that? Zeros, we don't want to preserve, neither we want to override. Why we want to override? Because we just, the moment zero has come, immediately we are looking for the one, not there may be several zeros and then maybe one. Such case we are not looking, right? We are looking for a zero, soon after zero then one. But this one, overriding this one, because this is the possibility, no? Several ones may come and then zero may come. So that's why for that one we are overriding. For this zero we are not overriding. Is that clear why this is not correct? Is that clear, the guys there who are real?
Yes.
Those who are especially learning, you should get this concept. So, okay, now, this is completely at once, how to clear, I don't know. Okay, so just a moment. I cleared almost. That's why we don't override. What we do is, we go to this state, again we start checking. 0 comes, we go to this state, again we start checking out this 1 occurrence. Because that's what we can do. If after this 1, after this 0, if 0 coming, we don't want this such 0 arrival. So we go to the beginning, again we start checking for such pattern. That's why we go to the reset state. If 1 coming, then we have to think where to go. If 1 is coming, 1, 0, 1, yes, we want this 1. So if 1 coming, can I go to this state? Means no, we cannot go, because the output, if you see the output here, output is 0 in this state. So we cannot go to that state. So for that, what we do is we go to another state. Let us say that is S3, and then this is the state 1, output is 1. Just let me quickly write that. We go to this one here when 1 has come, and this is our state, and this is our S3, and output is 1. So we have reached 101, and output is 1. That is what we have this one. After that, now since this is non-overlapping, so we cannot go to this any other zero. We are not looking for immediately zero, non-overlapping. Since it is a non-overlapping, we are not looking for this immediate zero. What is that we are looking for is 1. 1, 0, 1, and then 1, since it is non-overlapping. So a fresh 1 occurrence is here. If you see here this one, we can go here. Where 1 is coming. Because this is the state of, again we are holding the 1 and then 0 like that. If 0 coming, 1, 0, 1 is done. If 0 coming, we go to the reset state. 0 coming, we go to the reset. Is that clear now? This complete state diagram to everyone there, especially who are learning. Is this clear? No one respond. Can I just someone unmute and tell whether is that clear? Are you people there?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
So this is clear. So now we have to develop a Verilog SDL code for this now, this state diagram. So what is that we can conclude? Let me select this one here. Once I want to clear, I don't know. Okay. Now, from this, what we have to do, we have to develop a Verilog SDL code. So, for that, let me take a text here. So, if I take text, what I can do, module, I think I have to include the font here. Is this visible to everyone there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, just a moment. I read the text here. Okay. Okay. Now, what is that we do? Module. Now, this is FSM 101. Module name, I gave just like that. Now, what are the inputs to this module that is important for us? Inputs are, one is a clock, one is a reset, and in the pattern itself, so that is and out. out is that when that pattern is met, so that is what I am planning, like that. And now what I do is input ELK, my reset, and my in, and my output here is output, and what is that out. And then what I have to do here is I move to this one here, I put always. I put always. What I have to do is I have to have idea. What is that idea is? Let me go to where is that. I have to go here, this one. You know this, just a moment. Let me clear this one. Now, what is our idea? It's a, which type of machine it is? A Moore or Mealy that we discussed now?
Moore, sir.
It's a Moore. So, in a Moore, we know that there is a input block, combinational or next state generation block, and we have output block. That is, this is a, your flip-flops here. Flip-flops, they take this next state. They are taking next state. This is next state generation logic, NSL, next state GL, generation logic. So this is taking NS. Now this is the current state. This is the current state. This current state is going here, and some current state like fed back here, and input is also coming. So now this flip-flop is getting a CLK and also having a reset. So from this figure we have to get this. Our out is this, our out is this, and our in is this, and this is the top module. Actually this is the top inside, everything is there, and outside accessible is this CLK and this reset. So this is your CLK and this is your reset. Now your top module, what it has? In, CLK, reset, and out. Everything, this is inside. So everything inside you should be able to imagine to develop the code. So what is happening at this point, flip-flop, when I apply the clock, this current state is actually assigned with the next state. Is it not? This current state, when I apply the clock, this next state is assigned, right, to the current state, no? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, when I apply reset, this current state will go to a known state, and that known state I am calling, let us say, the zero. So, this I am going to model first with that idea. This picture should be in mind. So, now I am going to model that one here. So, now what I do here is, I just write, what is that? Add pause edge. This is just a moment. I have to bring here this text. At always at this pause at CLK clock, and my idea here is this is a synchronous. This one is a synchronous clock, so that's why in sensitivity list I did not include here. So now what I do is always at pause edge clock. If reset. Then my idea is, if you see that again, lower if you go, next current state is assigned with a zero. Else, you can, what is this? Else. Now, what is that happening? Current state is assigned with a next state. That is the point here happening. And even this current state, you can bring it to some known state also. Yes, not. Suppose say when you are pressing a reset, yes, not. Let us say yes, not. If it's not zero, yes, not. This portion is this portion. This portion. We have done this. Since this is a combinational logic, this is a combo, combinational logic, and this is also another combo. combination logic two. This is dependency. If you see, dependency is on in and what is this? This one. This is current state, right? Are you getting? Hello there. Those specially learning, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
This combinational, first combinational logic dependency is on in and this yes. So let us model that one now here. So if you model that one here, that is always a dependency of this here is in, comma, and your combinational logic. Now inside that, what we are going to do, that is again begin. What we are going to do here inside, just a moment, I'll come back here. Now in this, what we are going to do, we check, being in this current state, we check the input here. Like if you go to the state diagram, this is your current state. In this current state, being in this current state, what you are doing, you are checking your input here. What is my input? Depending upon your input, you are making movements. You are going to the another state. So that is what you are doing. So that exact thing we have to code here. And what is that is the output here? You see output of this combinational logic, the next state, right? Hello, everybody there, especially learning guys. This first combinational logic, if you see, the first combinational output is what? Next state, no? And if the dependency is in and current state, right? So we check the input being in one state, that is case we have to develop, case statement. We have to translate this one to here, case. And then being in this one state, we have to check the input. And what we have to update? Update the next state. That we have to do. So for that, from here I am going to somewhere down here because I have to preserve that figure also. Just a moment, select and I have to clean all this. This portion. Okay. Now, guys, there, remember from begin, I am moving down here. From begin, I am moving down and coming to case statement. Case, what is that in the case I have to put? CS, current state I have to put. So, after case, then what I have to do? I have how many cases there? Yes, not this one case I have. All right. Then I have yes, one and yes, two and yes, three. Is it not? You go there, here. Yes, zero, yes, one, yes, two, yes, three. Yes, zero, yes, one, yes, two, yes, three. Is that clear to everyone why these states here?
Yes, sir.
Now, being in this yes, zero, what I have to do is if I had to check my in, if in happens to be one, what is my next state that I am going to update? My next state is yes, one, else. My next state is, just a moment, this text in the paint, I have to handle it carefully. Next state is yes, not itself. So that is done. Now what I do is, I come to the another state, this yes one state. In that again, if I n, then what is my next state? I have reached to the one. From there, what is my next state? If one is coming, I still remain in that yes one. Else, what is my next state? My next state is yes, two. Is it not? This one, yes, one. Being in yes.
Sir, can we conditional statement, sir, rather than using if else statement? If else statement, can we go for conditional statement, sir? If NS is equal to in question mark S1, S not, like that.
That also you can use the ternary operator. You want to say ternary operator.
Yes, sir. Is it synthesizable under case?
Yes. It is synthesizable.
Okay. But can we, this one, as we are going for blocking statements,
This is see this portion. If you figure, if you see the figure carefully, this figure. What is this figure? This figure is a input side combinational block, right?
Yes, sir.
So combinational blocks are modeled with this blocking assignment operator only.
Yeah, I got it, sir. Thank you, sir.
So that's why this figure I am not removing. I am not cleaning because this figure is our for us reference. This figure. Is that clear?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now being in S1, what we did, if one coming, we remained in that state when one has come. When zero has come, we move to the S2. So that's why we modeled here in that way. Now in a S2, if you go to your state diagram, in a state diagram, if one is coming, then we are going to the S3. Otherwise, we are going to the S0. That we have to model now. So let us model that. So being in S2, if let us model that way what you have said. So IN, that is what is that we have to NS should be. What is that? Can you help me out?
In question mark, NS is equal to
NS equal to
in question mark
S3
colon
S0. Let us go and see. Okay, let us go to the S2. If S2, if one is coming, we are going to S3, otherwise we are going to the S0. So this is the correct model. Is that clear to everyone, this one?
Yes, sir.
You only spoke, right, about this now?
Yes, sir.
The other guys, those who are watching, you have to unmute and tell, is this clear? We are now, two things we have presented here with if, and this is our ternary operator. Is that clear to everyone there present? No one.
Yes, sir.
What is the meaning of this means? Is the ternary operator we are checking? This is IN. Is that true? IN, is that true? If true, then this is executed. This is executed means this is assigned to this NS. If IN happens to be zero, then S0 is assigned to this NS. That's what this ternary operator uses, and that is synthesizable. So that is very much synthesizable. Hopefully this is clear. The one who now spoke, who helped this to get this statement, for him also is clear now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this usage is also synthesizable. This usage is also synthesizable. So now let us go to the other one here. If we put if, and then that is IN, then next state is, what is our next state being in a one? Let us go to the state diagram. That's why state diagram we have to all the time keep. In a one, if coming, then going to S1 state. If zero coming, S1. So being in S3, one coming means S1. So let us go to S1. Semicolon, else. Let us go to what is that? S0. Okay. So that's how this is done, and we have to finish this with a case also. End case. And guys, there this is. In case here latches will be developed, if you don't, we talk about, I think time, we are running out of time here. The problem with this sort of case statement here is it produces latches if you don't complete. How many here we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 means we have to use here, let us say we are using a parameter that is for S0. That is S0, 0, comma S1. That is 1. What is happening here? I have to get this one here. Okay. Now comma, that is S2. That is 2. And then S3. That is 3. And then semicolon. And then we also have to tell about the CS and the NS usage also to the compiler. So that array in this just a moment. I have to get this one here. Here, and now let me take the text here and let me put here reg what's that, one colon zero, and then that CS comma NS and then semicolon. So now if you see carefully here, how many total four states are there, and the ability of having the possible cases are four, because of four, two bits are enough, and if you go to this case, all four been met, so no issues. It shouldn't be producing a latch. In case if you end up with the S0, in case if you end up with the S0, S1, S2, and this case is not defined, and if you leave like that, then synthesizer will generate a latch which is unintentional. So in order to overcome that, we have to put default. If neither of the case is met, what is you thought of having to do? Maybe you still want to remain in yes not state, suppose. So that if you put, then this latch will not be produced by the synthesizer tool. That we have to understand how this case is translated to hardware mapping. So guys, this importance here is default. If all case values are not met, then default statement is required. If default statement is not mentioned, then unnecessary latch will produce unintentional latch. In order to overcome that unintentional latch, we have to have default statement. So with that said, let us complete very quickly because we are running out of time. So guys, there we have done this input side combinational block. Now let us very quickly come to this output combinational block. Output combinational block, if you see, it is solely depending upon the current state. So you can do it with a one combinational, that is a one always block. Otherwise, straight assign statement also you can write for this. So either way is very good. Either way is possible. No problem. Let us put a assign statement. If you put an assign, then what is that this guy is doing? Output guy is producing output depending upon your current state in a more state machine. So let us go to this assign and take your out here, and our brother somebody helped earlier in the same style here, current state, when that current state is equal to. So what is that we have to do here is current state equal to which one, that is S3. When S3, then question mark. If that is true, then one take B1, else one take B0. Is that clear to everyone there? Here, what is this we have done? This one is about this combinational block here, this output combinational block. Guys, is that clear? When this current state is equal to, according to our state diagram, is S3, then output should be 1. So that is what exactly we are doing here, this one output. When we are comparing CS current state with S3, if that is true, then 1 is assigned to out, else 0 is assigned to out. Is that clear to everyone there? No one does.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is semicolon here we have to put. So with that said, now what is left here is end module. So finally, we have to put a end module. So that's how with this, let us quickly summarize this. What we have, what is essential here is to develop any FSM, we have to have state diagram number one, and this mind, in our mind, this should be there. What is Moore style machine? What is a Mille state machine? How input combinational block is dependent on what variables? And output combination block dependent on what variables. This, if it is there in our mind, and how these flip-flops sequential circuits are working, if that is there in our mind, depending upon the clock and reset, what is really happening, then we can happily code this one here. This portion being coded with a clock and non-blocking assignment operator, just because if you see this figure, this is a sequential circuit. Sequential circuits are coded blindly with a non-blocking assignment operator. You shouldn't be using blocking assignment operator. For combinational circuit, if you see the input side, this one here, it is a combinational. That's why this portion we are using here, this blocking assignment operators. So similarly, if you see the output side, combinational logic here, this one, you can model with always also. Otherwise, with a simple assignment also, we'll do like this. So guys, with this said, earlier we said about the case statement, case one, how important minding case one if you use. I think you people will remember that. So let us wrap this tutorial session and let us make some announcements.